Here we have an EVGA graphics card. This is the 1070. It came in for no power. Customer said that the card smoked and it would not power on anymore. I'm looking at the card and I'm trying to figure out where that card smoked from. Smoke is sometimes a good thing because we can tell where that problem came from. And I think I see something here. Oh yeah. MOSFET for the memory. And look at this. This cap does not look good. The MOSFET itself may not be good. This cap is blown. And I do not know if there's anything else wrong with this board. And there's something bulging from here. Let's go ahead and remove those components. Let's start by removing this capacitor. I'm gonna remove the MOSFET and this guy here. And we're gonna inspect the rest of the board to see if there's anything else obvious. What happened to you? Oh, what's that? You cut yourself?
Mm-mm.
What?
I was bleeding.
What do you mean? How?
So like when I was at gymnastics, when I went out, I was crying, so I didn't want anyone to see me. So I was hiding in the bushes. There was something like sharp and it made me bleed and I was crying. But and then my coach Julia, she got me a bandage and I was like, "Phew, I stopped crying." I'm waiting for the platelet to come so I can take it off. Platelet. You know what the platelet is? See the bandage?
Yellow, wait, just give me a second. I'm trying to take this off and it's not coming off.
Maybe I can help?
Look, I'll show you. This one.
Maybe I could help?
How? See, it's not coming off. Look.
But how is it gonna come off?
Well, we have to heat it like this and then it should come off, but it's stuck for some reason. The black?
Yeah, see the black?
Yeah.
So if you keep on heating it, it'll be out.
Oh, you're right. Look at this. It came off. You're absolutely right.
See, I told you.
You're smart. I mean, how fixable is this board? That's the question. Looks like the whole family is coming in today. Okay, wait. I don't think I can work today. Here.
Puppy. And puppy.
Wait. Bus. Bus.
Bus.
One mustache.
One
beard. Beard. One mustache. One eyes. One nose. One. Tummo. Sinno. When sinno? When sharato? Okay. Bye bye. Now, if we continue with the inspection of the board. I do not see anything else obvious on this side of the board. Let me look under that MOSFET on back of the board and see if there's anything obvious there. Just want to see if there's anything obvious. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Just what I thought. I've had that problem before where we had damage on front of the board and exactly on back of the board, that area, we had damage also, like what you see here. let me desolder those capacitors. So the pad is gone. And right now we do not know if that MOSFET is good or not. Let's go ahead and plug the card in just to see if anything changed. And we're gonna power the motherboard on. Okay, the computer is on. And usually if the video card is in no detect, we get 6 beeps. So right now we're not getting any beeps. And while at it, let's inspect the board under a thermal cam. And look at this. I see a hot spot at the MOSFET. So we most likely have to change that MOSFET. Look at this. Maybe. Look at this. We have heat at the MOSFET. And I think by replacing that MOSFET, the video card may be a fix. We'll resolder those caps later on, but the caps are not gonna prevent the video card from powering on. So let's replace that MOSFET. We're gonna grab that MOSFET from a donor. All right, so we're gonna solder it right here. Before we do, let's prep the board. Let's go ahead and solder that MOSFET, but the flux is not usually yellow, but this flux is combined with the one that was under the chip. All right, press and hold down. Yeah, we should be good. Okay, so let's go ahead and try the card. The card should work even with the capacitors off. I just want to make sure the card is working and we can figure out what those capacitors are and replace them later. But the main thing is we need that card to work. Okay. And let's turn that motherboard on. And let's see. Yeah, right there. Right there. It's working. It's working. Awesome. Awesome. The card is working. Now all we have to do is look at the similar donor board, extract those capacitors, and put them back on. In most cases, those are bypass capacitors. They are used to filter. They're not going to affect the functionality of the board, but we're gonna find out what those capacitors are. We're gonna replace one, two, and two on the back. We're gonna end the video right here. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and we'll do something else in the next video.